Let me just remind you that Joshua clottey is in my studio. We picked him right from the airport, and this happens to be his first major interview on the soil of Ghana after that Manny Pacquiao game. So just some credit to GTV for making sure that we get Joshua clottey in the studio. Joshua, welcome back. Freddie Roach, the trainer of Pacquiao, made a comment after the fight that you are one of the best defensive boxers he has seen ever since he entered into that sport. But defending alone do not win bouts. Do you share that same opinion with him?
Yeah, he's right. But you see, if you watch my fight with Kodo, yeah, I was not just defending without punching.
Yeah.
I was defending punching.
But you threw more punches in that bout than this one.
That's why I told you, now that you say the thing,
yeah,
that's why I told you that I don't have a day. You know, in every business you do in life, there's only half day. So I don't have a day because as soon as I work my way in, I can't even do nothing, you see. But I take it like one of those things, you know. It happens to me. I'm now experienced about it.
Joshua, did you struggle to make the 147 pounds?
Of course, yes. It's the main factor about my knockout ratios now. As you can see, I can't even knock people anymore nowadays.
Why?
Because of the 147. I'm too big, you know.
You are from a bigger water weight.
Too much. I'm bigger than everybody in that weight.
Mm.
From my legs to the top. I'm too big, so sometimes I wear a lot of stars before I go. I wear about five top and about five top down before I make the weight. I eat once in a day, so as you can see, it's a sacrifice that I'm making for the nation and everybody.
You put in a lot of effort, and when the commentator said that you are representing thousands and millions of Africans and said the grandmaster, then I knew that this man was representing the continent of Africa. But Joshua, have you heard that HBO is thinking of taking you off their list?
You know, when you hear something like that from Fight News, boxing scene, then it's true. But when you heard it from somewhere, it's
from obscure sources.
Exactly. You know, HBO are professionals. They can never come out and say that we're not going to allow Joshua to fight in our network again. I call the HBO, the Tuffet, he's the director of the HBO pay-per-view. I asked him, this is what I heard. And he said, he doesn't even know about that. And Bob Arum, I have 1 year contract with Bob Arum.
Sure, top ranks.
But he said he likes me. I'm very humble. He loved me to give me 2 more years. So we signed 2 more years to the 1 year.
So there is a contract extension.
Exactly. So I don't know where they get all that thing from. HBO don't want to put me in the addition. Whatever. You know, end of the day, I don't have a contract with HBO. I have a contract with Bob Arum.
Top ranks.
So if top rank bring good fights, HBO think this is a good fight for the people, they will promote it.
Joshua, at a point in time, if you had been a little bit aggressive, if you had, you know, pushed in a bit, you would have been able to knock out Manny Pacquiao.
And I said that you have to know that when you go to a business and it's not working, you fox yourself, you made a very big mistake and it will hurt you tomorrow. You see? So if I push a little bit, if that will kill me, nobody is going to see me again. You see? I am trying to lose up, trying to vibrate myself. That's the reason why I'm dancing to the ring, to forget about what is happening. You see, but when I get it, still work. It still can't go on. You know, people have to understand that this is not the way I fight. They have to forgive me and let me move on with my life. After this interview that I'm making with you right now,
you are not talking.
After that,
me.
I'm not gonna talk to nobody about this. Okay? Because when we're talking about the past, it hurt the future.
Sure.
So I don't want to talk about it.
So yesterday is gone.
Exactly.
We tomorrow must concentrate on tomorrow.
Tomorrow is better than yesterday because you don't know what is going to be in tomorrow. So I want all Ghanaians to forget about that issue.
Yeah.
It comes. We all praying for that. It comes. I know it doesn't work. We have to forget about it so that I will move on with my life because I'm in do and die affair now. People don't know that I'm in do affair now with my career. This is how it is. I lost 2 on a row. So if I lost 3 on a row, then I'm not a world class fighter.
You are finished.
This is what they have to think and stop talking about Pacquiao thing. I lost. We have to talk about the present. For the more encouragement they give me, the more I want my next fight to come out of that danger.
Sure. But Joshua, do you foresee any fight coming so soon?
I am
just thinking that analytically you've lost to Manny Pacquiao, you've lost to Miguel Angel Cotto, but maybe the credible boxer that is likely to fight you might be Andre Beto.
Well, you see, we can't even say anything about it because you don't even know that I'm going to fight with Pacquiao.
It just came when Floyd Mayweather chickened out.
Exactly. People came to the TV and they said, I lost to Cotto. They don't think that I'm going to get a big fight. I get more than big fights because they know God. Almighty Allah is blessing me so crazy because I am so humble. In America, the media said I am the most humble boxer they know.
Probably because of your skin?
Because
you come from?
Because I respect everybody. I do what people that they know will not do because I know that this is life. Where you're going to make the money to take care of the family is more important. So definitely fights, I'll get a lot of fights. Right now they're talking about me getting to the ring in August. I tell them I'm not
this
yet.
This year, August?
August.
Three months away from
yeah, now. I tell them no. Let me think. Maybe September will be better, October will be better.
Joshua, your body language when you came out of the limousine at least gave some of us the impression that you know, you were not prepared for the fight. What happened before the fight?
Well, you see, people make money. When you try to do like them, you're going to fall for it. And end of the day, if it's bad, you're going to pay. You see, you don't know the reason why people make their money. Pray to your Almighty Allah to make sure that you make something good. You know, we don't even know how every opponent fights or do before comes to the ring and fight. Sometimes we face obstacles on the road. We don't know how it is. People have to understand. It wasn't me there because I'm trying to push myself, make sure that I put myself together and come out like Joshua Clottey. Still doesn't work. They have to know that I heard so many things about Pacquiao. I don't want to talk about it. But I want people to know that they have to forgive me. I have to move on with my career. It's very important.
Joshua, your fight against Margarito, 2nd December 2006, you lost one of your fingers in your gloves. After the fourth one, some of us were thinking you were going to win that particular bout. It's the same title bout that you went for, the WBO. You've lost it once again. Now, you won against Judah, of course. You won the IBF title. You lost against Miguel Angel Cotto. You've lost against Manny Pacquiao. Two on the trot. You don't want to lose for the third time. People are saying that every fight you lose, you give out too many excuses.
Well, I don't give excuse. That's why in the after press conference of the fight, I told everybody, this is the first time I lost a fight.
That you have seen genuinely that you have lost.
Genuinely that I have lost a fight. Mm. I did not lose to Cotto. Mm. I won. Even I have a road to Dallas. Mm. I can give to GTV to show.
Yo.
You see, Pacquiao said Joshua Clottey won the fight with Cotto. Cotto himself knew. Everybody knew that.
That is why he didn't come again.
Exactly. And that's the reason why Pacquiao chose to fight me. You see, I lost to Margarito because I got injured. People scored after the fight draw. You see, I lost to Pacquiao. I lost. I did not give excuse. The whole thing turned against me, and I don't know why it's supposed to do. It's supposed to come like that.
Happen
because
that way.
I never know that I'm talking to somebody. And the person framed the whole thing in a different way. Give it to me. I accept them because I know when Almighty Allah is blessing you, you see so many obstacles. You have to fix them. I have the will and power to face all those obstacles. And nobody's gonna say bad things about me, saying that, oh, this guy have made some money, he don't respect nobody, he don't do that. No, I'll be humble like I am because that's how I am.
Joshua, did you grant any interview telling the Ghanaians that you ate some food and that might have caused your inability to, you know, stand in the ring as strong as you've been?
Well, I make interview with one guy, I think he's sitting here from or something like that. You see?
And what did you tell him?
I never eat banku before. I don't know how to eat
banku. Your whole life?
No. I eat only keke. Mm. I think banku is too praying to be eat. Mm. But because Kenke, they put in something and they boil it before you, that's why he Kenke. You see, so I don't know where it comes from that the guy said, I eat okra stew and banku. I eat okra stew. Behind the scene, I'm telling my people what happens to me before I get to the ring. I'm expecting my people to tell me, Next time, if you know this is the problem, next time, don't do that again. I never tell the person to put out there and frame the whole thing and for people to talk about. But you know what, like I said, you see,